Hello, I'm Dr. Jeff from the Standard. Happy to see you again. Time passed so fast. Friday will be the year of Ox. I wish every Standard reader a very healthy, happy, and prosperous new year. Ox, always hardworking. I hope those hardworking people can have reward in the new year. Now, let's talk about individual shares. The first share I want to recommend to you is China BlueChemical, code number 3983. It manufactures fertilizer and agricultural chemicals, including urea, methanol, and phosphorus fertilizers. So in 2018, the net profit of this company is 1.37 trillion RMB. In 2019, the net profit dropped to 703 million RMB, so dropped almost half in 2019. But in 2020, it just issued a profit expectation with the range from 717 million to 757 million. That means around 2 to 10% growth compared with 2019. So it's recovering. A few reasons. The economy is recovering, GDP rising, US dollar is weak. So please look at the chart of the urea. You can see is in the last few months, the price of urea is rising. And Hong Kong stock market, we can see many raw material shares, metal mining shares, oil resources. Those sectors have gone up a lot. But this share, relatively speaking, is still a lagger. Another reason to support this company is those Chinese government's policy. You may have heard about the number one central document of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of China on increasing efforts on major work concerning agriculture, rural area, and rural people to ensure the goal of building a moderately prosperous society in all respect and achieve on time. So there are 2 points. First, win the battle against poverty. Second, speed up to improve infrastructure and public service in rural area to build a moderately prosperous society in all respect according to relevant standard. So this is the government policy to support agriculture sector and also helping people against poverty. Recently, there's not much news about this area, but I expect more news or stimulative policy will come. So another factor you can consider is about the companies. The company will have an opportunity to arising from the construction of Hainan Free Trade Port and promote the development of petrochemical wharf project. This has been mentioned in their annual report. But Hainan Free Trade Port concept shares start to rise. This China BlueChemical will be a beneficiary. So today the stock price went up by around 9% to $2. I should have recommended to you earlier. But if you're looking about the 3-year chart, the share price fell from $3.2 in 2017 to less than $1 in 2019. So it keep falling in the last 2 years, but only start to go up again in the last 3 months. So there's still more room to grow, because even though it went up from $1 level to near $2, the PE ratio is only around, expected PE is only around 11 times with a 4% yield. So it is not expensive at all, and the valuation is attractive. The second share I want to mention to you is Higher Smart Home, code number 6690. It is the leader in the global major home appliance industry, especially manufacturing refrigerator and laundry machine. The group ranked first in the major home appliance industry in the world in terms of retail volume of major home appliances for 9 consecutive years from 2011 to 2019, with a market share of 14.7% in 2019. Its business covers more than 160 countries and regions around the world, including China, North America, Europe, South Asia, Southeast Asia, Australia, New Zealand, Japan, Middle East, and Africa. In 2019, its revenue was 198 billion renminbi. The compound annual growth rate was 13.3% in the previous 3 years. In 2019, the gross profit is 58.6 billion renminbi. Compound annual growth rate in the last 3 years is 8%. The net profit in 2019 was 8.2 billion renminbi, which is equivalent to 9.8 billion Hong Kong dollar. It currently has a market cap of 322 billion Hong Kong dollar. So the historical PE is around 32 times. So based on its size and its growth potential and the world economy recovery, so this company should be a very defensive company with steady growth. So what is the growing point in this company? The potential, where is the potential? Okay, so this is the first home appliance enterprises in the industry to launch smart home solution. So you can see the name of the company is Higher Smart Home. So they have developed an app. So you just download the apps, and then this app will be supported by the introduction of Group's cloud-based platform. So using this app, you can connect all the smart home appliances automatically to the preset orders, covering refrigeration appliances, kitchen appliances, air conditioners, laundry appliances, and water appliances. So imagine if this company, you buy all the home appliances from them, and you download the app, and then you can control the by preset order. So when you go out for dinner, and before you come back, you want to turn on the air conditioner, so you can set and control by the app, so that the air conditioner will be turned on first before you come back. Or if you want to scare the people away from your home, you can turn on the light, or you can turn off the light as you like. Anyway, just joking. So look at the chart of this company, the stock chart. It was listed last December and gradually went up from $24 to currently $36 level. I expect that it will clear the all-time high very soon. So this year, I'm sure it will go up to above 40. Not exciting, but defensive and steady growth. So I think you can consider to put this share into your portfolio as well. Okay, look at the US market. Monday night, Dow Jones Index and Nasdaq Index both cleared the all-time high. Dow Jones Index closed at 31387, up 237. Nasdaq Index closed at 13987, up 131 points. Both are all-time high and also close at the near the day high. So technically, it sounds good. And actually, there's some reason behind. The US Senate and the Congress has decided to let the President, Joe Biden, to speed up the progress to approve the $1,900 billion stimulative package. So this is a good news. Another good news is the S&P 500 shares. Most of them has reported Q4 earnings, and most of them are better than expected, such as Google and Amazon. And for the unemployment data, job, the labor market is not that bad. And the week before, those jobless claim people, the number is around 779K, which is less than the expected number, 830K. So looking at these fundamental factors, so US stock market, renewed the record high, they had the reason behind. And for the Hong Kong Hang Seng Index, let's look at the chart. So if you look at this weekly chart, you can see that the Hang Seng Index has cleared a medium-term resistance. So technically, it looks good. And there's some fundamental reason that you should be keeping optimistic about the stock market. I want to talk about more fundamental factor to support the Hong Kong stock market. Actually, the liquidity is still very abundant. The chief executive of Hong Kong Monetary Authority, Mr. Eddie Yu, yesterday presented many facts against Ma Yi. Since he took up the position in October 2019, 16 months passed. Unfortunately, Hong Kong had social unrest and the geopolitical tension and also COVID-19 pandemic. However, Hong Kong financial center status is still very stable and financial sector remain relevant and highly competitive. So people will ask, is the money moving away from Hong Kong? On the contrary, we have seen recording net inflow. The Hong Kong dollar is strong compared to US dollar. Today it is around 7.75, and actually most of the time remain in the strong half of the convertibility zone. That means below 7.8. Is the banking deposit shrinking? The answer is no. And actually, the banking deposit rose 2.9% in 2019. In 2020, it rose another 5.4%. So did many Hong Kong people open offshore accounts and move their money away? The answer is no. Maybe somebody would like to open an offshore account, but they are not taking action to move the money away. For example, the private banking industry, the asset under management, AUM, went up by 19% in 2019. And in 2020, another double-digit growth is expected. So Hong Kong still remains the biggest private banking industry in management center in Asia, biggest one. Just second to Switzerland in the world. How about those financial institutions, hedge fund, exchange trade funds, private equity funds? Are they moving away from Hong Kong? The answer is no. The number of asset managers in Hong Kong increased by 3.9% from 1,808 to 1,878. So the number is increasing. And for those private banking clients, how many assets are they having? It is US dollar 4 trillion at the end of 2019. So a lot of fund is still here. It went up by 20% in 2019. And for the private equity, Hong Kong has a capital under management, US dollar 160 billion. So again, Hong Kong is very important. And among the top 20 private equity firms in the world, 15 of them have presence in Hong Kong, and most of them are regional headquarters. So how about Hong Kong IPO market? In 2020, we are the second in the world, just next to NASDAQ. But in last 12 years, we got number one in 7 years. And for stock connect between China and Hong Kong, the average daily turnover is more than double in 2020, with northbound traffic going up by 119% and southbound going up by 128%. And now around 70% of all A shares being held by international investors can be traded in Hong Kong. So, last point, Mr. Eddie, you mentioned, is about the number of jobs in the financial market. Actually, in the finance industry, about 0.7% growth was being seen last year. And in the industry of insurance, about 1.4% increase in the number of jobs, despite, in general, the unemployment rate is increasing. But the finance and insurance industry, the number of jobs is still growing.